obey traffic laws, be alert, and use voice commands while driving. Please proceed to the highlighted route, and so then the route guidance will start.
I can't proceed to the required route or whatever because I can't get into drive.
Mary, Stacy, Spirit, and Sophie, we're taking our motor home around the country. Throughout North America, we're on the road. It's Powhana Travels, here we go.
Well, that's it, everyone. We have done Northern Georgia, I think, a pretty good justice for the past 3 days, hanging out with our friends Tony and Shelley Van Beers. Today we are moving up to North Carolina. We're gonna add a new sticker to our map, and we're gonna start off in North Carolina in Asheville. So enjoy the drive today, and we'll see you in Asheville.
A situation.
Yep.
So we've had this happen one other time, and the gear selector will not come out of park.
Even with the foot on the brake, dirty in there. With my foot on the brake, the gear selector still doesn't come out of park. So I've looked at some other videos, and there might be a little latch down here somewhere that I can unhook. But I don't know yet.
Okay.
I'm pressing them.
Nothing.
Wow. So brake lights don't work. So the brake light relay that sends a signal to the brake lights probably also activates this release in here. And since that little relay is not working, I'm guessing we're kind of in a standstill until we can find that little relay. And do you see a parts store anywhere?
Well, we are at the mall.
Yeah, we're not the right kind of mall. We're not at the auto parts mall. We're at the stupid other mall.
We might have to use an Uber.
We'll see what happens. Yeah. All right. Yeah, so we're at Advanced Auto Parts here in Asheville. This is not necessarily is suggested for your regular tour stops. When you're touring down through Asheville, normally you'd like to go to like the breweries and maybe go hiking on some Blue Ridge trails or something like that. But no, we end up going to Advanced Auto Parts.
Truck is stuck at Best Buy.
We had to take Uber or Lyft or whoever it was to the auto parts store, and we're going to have to Uber or Lyft back to the truck. All for a little $30 part. This is a faulty guy. Little brake position switch or brake switch or something like
that.
Hope that's the problem. Another successful Uber ride, I guess. We got back to the truck. I got the part. I'm going to get down and install it, and hopefully it works, because if it doesn't work, then it's a tow.
This is the culprit. This is a brake relay switch, and this is what we had to go buy. This is the old one.
I got the new one down here. All right, that took a total of about 2 minutes to install. Let's see. Oh shit.
Are you messing with
me? No, I'm not messing with you. I didn't do it.
So this is what happens with real RV life.
Woohoo! Yeah, baby!
Unfortunately, this isn't with the RV, this is with our truck. So what we've got to do now, one thing, we as escapers and escapees members, we have purchased their roadside assistance program, and we have used it more than, this will be the second time this year, so well worth the expense of that, and it covers all vehicles. The first time we used it was also for the truck. So next thing we need to do is call a tow truck and see if we can get a rental car here. So I need to get on my phone and get working. RV life.
So well, here we are. We still have the truck. We didn't drop it off at Ford.
So yeah, we're rednecking it and jerry-rigging it.
And all that good stuff just to make it work. And you know what? It wasn't worth spending an extra couple of days well.
It would have been nice, but we have family we want to see. And you guys, it's cold. We want to go to the ocean.
Right. And you know, we'll come back and do Asheville sometime later again and do it more justice. Today we kind of lost the whole day because of the truck issue.
We lost the entire day.
Yes. But now, you know what? We are downtown Asheville right now. We're going to go actually find some grub, maybe some beer, maybe something else, and see what we can find. See what Asheville has to offer us a little bit.
Yeah, it's 9 o'clock, so we've got some catching up to do.
By the way, what we're filming this on now is our new little camera that we just picked up.
So now we're on the Canon M50.
Yes, so we'll see how it goes from here on out.
Let's go find food.
Yes, please. You think it's about Christmas time?
We finally found some Christmas lights.
Yes, really pretty downtown here in this little square. The trees are all decorated. They got some big snowflake right here. It's really nice. Jason, we found a fire department in Asheville. It's right there. We always kind of seek out fire departments just because my brother has been a county firefighter for the last, 10, 15, 20 years, not 20 years, at home. and so in honor of him, we always kind of search out fire departments and take looks and pictures if we can.
Well, good morning. Today is the day that we go visit America's largest estate, privately owned home.
Built by the Vanderbilt family. A long time ago, it's huge.
We're very much looking forward to it, and it's the reason why we came to Asheville.
Driving
not driving, and we're parked, and we're waiting to turn.
Continue on Biltmore Estate Drive for 3/4 mile.
Lovely day.
Yeah, heck of a lot better than yesterday, that's for sure. It must have rained 4 inches yesterday. This is nice out here. We got, blue sky, holy cow.
We haven't seen blue sky in a while.
No, we haven't. That's nice. We're on the path to the Biltmore house. I can kind of see it through the trees up there. It looks really big.
Well, so far it's been a very easy walk, and the grounds are absolutely beautiful.
I'm happy.
And the sun is shining.
Yep.
We began our day at the Biltmore with the upstairs downstairs private behind the scenes tour, where we descend the back stairs to explore the servants' life at the Biltmore. Our guide showed us the cutting-edge technology that kept America's largest home humming, including a central heating system that used natural convection to deliver steam heat, 5 refrigerators, which were all electrically powered, and 2 original Otis elevators that were the first in the Southeast United States installed in 1895, which are all still in service today. On our tour, we also visited the domains of the butler, head housekeeper, and ladies' maid. We then continued on to a suite of guest rooms and learned about the ground house parties that George Anita Vanderbilt would host. After our lunch in the Biltmore Stables, we took another behind-the-scenes tour that gave us some of the most amazing views from the rooftops and balconies of the Biltmore and got a closer look at the design and construction of the Biltmore house. The tour started at the model room, a room dedicated to the architecture of the house itself. From there, we entered the observation room and climbed up its spiral staircase to enter the rooftop balconies overlooking the estate grounds. The views from the rooftop were spectacular, and there's no doubt why George Vanderbilt decided to build his summer home here in Asheville. I am not 100% positive that this rooftop tour is going to continue in 2019. Both of our tour guides did tell us that the behind-the-scenes tours were changing, so be sure to see if this one is available, because it was well worth the $26 per person to go behind the scenes and get where no one else can go. An interesting fact, all roof repairs take place from inside the attics, and after seeing up close how steep the roofs are, it makes a lot of sense. Another fun fact, all the peach slate tiles are fastened to the roof with copper wire.
After finishing up our two behind-the-scenes tours, we finally got to tour the public areas of the house on a self-guided tour. The Biltmore house is even more magical when adorned for the holidays, complete with 55 hand-decorated trees, including the favorite 35-foot live Fraser fir in the biggest and most impressive room in the house, the banquet hall, with the massive triple fireplace and a 1916 Skinner pipe organ. The dinner table seats 38 with plenty of space for additional small tables. The Flemish tapestries are from the 1500s. As we tour the public spaces of the house, here are some epic stats on the home. The house has 250 rooms, including 35 bedrooms for family and guests, 43 bathrooms, 65 fireplaces, 3 kitchens, an indoor pool, bowling alley, and a 19th century novelties such as electric elevators, forced air heating, centrally controlled clocks, fire alarms, and a call bell system. The estate is the largest privately owned estate in America. At one time, the entire estate covered over 125,000 acres, but today it now sits on a modest 8,000 acres. The main residence is a chateau-style mansion built by prominent New York architect Richard Morris Hunt for George Washington Vanderbilt II between 1889 and 1895. Unfortunately, Hunt never saw the finished project as he died in July of 1895, and George officially opened the home to friends and family on Christmas Eve of that year. The library of the Biltmore House is a favorite room amongst guests and employees alike. It also happens to be the room that best reflects George's intellect and personality. A testament to his passion for books and collecting, the walls of the library are lined with walnut shelves housing George's personal collection of over 22,000 books. The home has been open to the public since 1930. However, during World War II and in 1942, 62 paintings and sculptures were moved off of the estate to the National Gallery of Art in Washington, D.C. to protect them in the event of an attack on the United States. The estate was dedicated as a National Historic Landmark in 1963. Still owned by George Vanderbilt's descendants, the Biltmore Estate today stands as one of the most prominent remaining examples of the Gilded Age. The house is assessed at $157.2 million, but due to agricultural deferment, county property taxes paid on the estate are only around $79.1 million. In addition to numerous gardens, the landscape architecture also established the first managed forest in the United States on the estate. The grounds and buildings of the estate have appeared in a number of major motion pictures and TV series, including Being There, The Last of the Mohicans, Forrest Gump, Patch Adams, and Hannibal, the movie, and the TV series. As we descend the stairs into the sub-basement of the house, we find ourselves in the Halloween room where dozens of pictures from the late 1800s document the build of the house. In order to facilitate such a large project, a woodworking factory and brick kiln, which produced 32,000 bricks a day, were built on site, and a 3-mile railroad spur was constructed to bring materials to the building site. Construction on the main house required the labor of well over 1,000 workers and 60 stonemasons. While touring the basement, we also find one of the nation's first bowling alleys installed in a private residence. The 70,000-gallon indoor swimming pool was heated 10 feet deep for easy diving and had underwater lighting, which still works today. Swimmers could step out of the pool and head to the wall near the door to push call buttons to order refreshments or request a dressing room. The surface hub of the house is also found in the largest basement in the U.S. as the location for the main kitchen, pastry kitchen, rotisserie kitchen, walk-in refrigerators that provided an early form of mechanical refrigeration, the servants' dining hall, laundry rooms, and additional bedrooms for staff. In all, we really enjoyed our day at the Biltmore. If we had to do it all over again, I would give ourselves more than one day to visit the estate. There are so many things we did not get to see, such as the gardens, the winery, and many hiking trails on property and other outdoor activities that are available for guests. One note, visiting the Biltmore is not cheap. Day passes for self-guided tours of the house start at $55 and can go as high as $85 per person based on popularity of the day. Advanced reservations are highly recommended. Also, children 9 and younger are free with a paying adult, and youth between 10 and 16 are half off. They do run specials on a second day pass, and I highly recommend that because one day is just not enough time to see it all. We want to thank you for watching today's episode of the Biltmore Estate. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. And if you haven't subscribed, please do so and hit that little bell so you're notified when we put up our next video. Mahalo for watching, and until next time, pau hana.
As always, if you like this video, please give us a thumbs up down below. Leave us a comment and subscribe to the channel if you haven't done so already. We thank you for watching.
Until next time, pau hana.